Welcome to this presentation where I will give some tips and tricks in order to be well prepared for the seminar in Hamburg. If we're looking at the experience from the last years, which I think is great to learn from, we can say that starting from scratch in the seminar was hard. So many students, some students, especially in the first year, did not know very much about the topic when they came to the seminar, and that meant that it was hard to have good and qualified discussions. It also took a long time to understand the interest and contributions from some of the other group members, so this time we have really tried to streamline the approach. Also, even if good plans were made during the seminar, the problem was that if the problem turned out to be different from what they really expected, they had to redo everything after a few weeks, which meant that it was very hard to get the best out of the seminar, because the whole idea about the seminar is that it's much easier to get the project started when you are sitting all together. So having to basically redo that exercise offline was not optimal. So this was often discovered in the first, we can say, investigative phase after the seminar. So as soon as the students from the different groups and different disciplines started to dig more into the topic, they realized this. Therefore, we think that the seminar will be much more fruitful when everyone is showing up well prepared. It makes it easier to get started for everyone, and it also makes it possible to make a more robust plan during the seminar. So the good question is, of course, we say it's important to be well prepared, but how to prepare? What we suggest that everyone is doing is really start to study the problem already from home to get a good problem understanding. So find relevant literature, other sources of information, be creative and critical, and really try to approach the problem with a broad mind to make sure that you really understand it. And understanding the problem can both be a technical discipline and understand the technical part of it, but it can also be to understand the context around it. Also, think carefully about how you can contribute to understanding the problem and develop solutions. So what is it that can be your contribution based on your knowledge and your interests? And how does it fit with what the requirements are to your study to make sure that it's also in line with what is expected that you basically are doing for your studies? Think about how you see your role in the project and the group, and also what you expect from other group members. So think about how you can contribute to the project, but also knowing who those project members are, who the other group members are, also think about how can you benefit from their knowledge, both in terms of content and in terms of collaboration. Also be aware that when you are starting with individual preparations, you might end up with different ideas or perspectives and opinions about approaches, because often when starting out with a broad and real world problem, the solutions can go in different directions and you might come up with different ideas. So it's important not to be too much locked on your own idea. On the other hand, this can also be a strength because it facilitates critical thinking and critical discussions. So what often happens is that if you are developing the problem analysis together, you quickly get into a group thinking, because one person is saying something and everyone thinks it's a good idea, and then you follow that path. Doing the first thinking individually will make it easier to think in different directions and have different perspectives. But of course, this is only a strength if it's really if everyone is open to hear other opinions and develop good solutions together. If not, it can really also lead to fight and discussions. So try to stay open-minded also when you are meeting in Hamburg. So the question for each, which is basically also the assignment here, is to make a one-page description about the following points before the meeting in Hamburg. So first of all, what did your initial research on the problem show? Then try to describe directions for potential solutions. It can be different directions, different ways to solve the problem. You don't have to say which is better or worse, but it's important to get the ideas up. And how do you see that you can contribute to solving it following the different directions of solutions? And also, as we talked about before, what do you expect from the other students in the group? It doesn't have to be a big report, just a one-page description which makes it clear that you have thought about and reflected about it and written it down so that you are ready for the discussions that will take place in Hamburg. I hope that this can help you to be more prepared during the seminar in Hamburg. Thank you very much for listening to the short presentation here.